Life is a roller coaster.
All right, Chris!
It has its ups.
A few weeks later.
And its downs.
All right, Chris?
Yeah. When do you think I can go home?
Soon. The doctors just need to monitor you for another day or two. I'll be back later to check on you. Just buzz us if you need anything.
I know I have CAH, but I've been taking my pills. What I need to understand is, why does a bug mean I miss a week of school while my friends only miss one day? No one has even told me what CAH really means. Gastro? Chi? What's going on?
You asked a medical question. That's like the magic phrase that makes us appear. Well, I guess in this instance, makes you appear.
You wish to discover more about CAH, and we wish to help.
Let's start with the basics. CAH stands for Congenital Adrenal Hyperplasia. Breaking that down, congenital means you're born with it. Adrenal means the condition affects the adrenal glands, and hyperplasia means that the adrenal glands are bigger than usual.
To help you understand CAH, we shall take you on a trip through Mediland, a planet that looks and works just like the human body.
First stop, the adrenal glands.
At Mediland's adrenal glands.
Chris, say hello to one of your adrenal glands. You've got two.
Whoa! What do the adrenal glands do?
They make hormones! Hormones are messengers that travel in your blood, delivering messages that help control lots of things in your body. Let's go see the hormones in action!
In the bloodstream.
One hormone is called cortisol. It controls blood sugar levels and helps the body deal with stresses like injury or infection.
Oh, dear, dear, dear. This just won't do. This blood needs more sugar, at least a cup or two.
Oh no, the salt levels are too low. We need more. Go, go, go!
Another hormone is called aldosterone. It controls blood pressure by telling the body how much salt should be in the blood.
Finally, the adrenal glands make hormones called androgens, but we'll get more into what they do later.
You'll have to wait and see to learn about me.
So this is what usually happens.
I'm guessing with CAH, things are not right. For example, I'm just going to make a casual observation and say that that adrenal gland does not look the right size.
Good observation. In CAH, the adrenal glands can't make cortisol and sometimes not enough aldosterone.
This means that the adrenal glands go into overdrive trying to make enough hormones. And this results in the glands getting bigger and bigger.
What are the glands so busy making?
Excellent question. And here comes the answer. Androgens.
Androgens are sex hormones made by both girls and boys. But people with CAH have much more androgens than other people. Because there is too little cortisol and aldosterone and too much androgen, it causes a hormone imbalance in the body. Getting a bit crowded in here, let's head back to HQ.
Back at MediKids HQ.
Okay, so the hormones are all out of whack, but what does that do?
Well, it causes changes called symptoms. And these symptoms are different for boys and girls.
The age when your symptoms appear and their severity depends on what type of CAH you have.
The first type is called classic CAH. Here, symptoms begin when you're a baby or young child.
When girls are born with CAH, there are sometimes changes to the genitalia. This can make it hard to know right away if they are a girl or a boy.
In the most severe form of CAH, there's no aldosterone, so loss of salt from the body is the biggest problem. Boys born with salt-losing CAH seem healthy at first, but within a few days of birth, they get sick, start throwing up, lose weight, and need to be taken urgently to the hospital.
That's what happened to me!
In children with non-salt-losing CAH, the salt balance is normal. In stressful situations, however, they can become salt losers and need treatment.
The mildest form is late-onset CAH, which can happen at any age. Some people with it have no symptoms.
Yeah, but others might have a growth spurt at a young age and extra hair on their body. Girls with this type of CAH might not get their periods.
So how do the doctors know if someone has CAH?
Great question. They'll do a blood test to check your hormone levels. As you can see, Mediland's blood has lots of androgens, but is missing cortisol and aldosterone.
Doctors might also do a genetic test to look for changes in your genes.
Is there anything we can do once we know it's CAH?
The answer to that is absolutely. Doctors can treat CAH by giving you hormones to replace the ones you're missing, so that you grow normally and stay healthy. Treatment will depend on your age and on the type of CAH you have. With classic CAH, you'll need to take these medicines every day for the rest of your life. Grab some hormones and let's go treat Mediland!
A quick teleportation later, and we're back in Mediland.
Thank goodness you're back. I've got no idea what to do with the salt. Is it too much? Too little? Help me!
Yeah, and does this place feel sweet enough to you guys? Or too sweet?
Don't worry, we've got you covered.
Glucocorticoids in the form of hydrocortisone pills replace the missing cortisol and act as substitute messengers that travel throughout the body to deliver the cortisol messages. Non-classic CAH can vary, and its treatment depends on the symptoms.
Mineralocorticoids, fludrocortisone pills, replace aldosterone and help control the amount of salt in the blood. During infancy, some babies with classic CAH may need to be given extra salt.
Replacement hormones also allow the quantity of androgens to fall into the normal range.
If you're getting replacement hormones, doctors will watch you closely to make sure your treatment is doing what it's supposed to, keeping your hormone levels balanced.
And for now, everything does seem back in balance for Mediland. So let us return to headquarters.
Understanding my CAH is great. Knowing I can treat it is even better. But it's still hard being different from my friends.
For sure, even a minor illness can make you much more unwell than your friends. And unlike them, you may even have to go to the hospital. This is because your blood sugar levels can drop when you are sick. When someone with CAH is sick, extra glucocorticoids are needed.
Living with CAH can be tough, especially since with classic CAH, you'll need to take your medicine every day for the rest of your life. But this is the best way to help make sure you stay healthy and well.
But, while that's the bad stuff, the good stuff is you've got a whole team of specialists that will take care of you and make sure you get the care and treatment you need.
And don't forget, you also have your family and friends. There's even a CAH support group to help you and your family learn about CAH and support you through its ups and downs.
You're right. Things get tough sometimes, but I've got a team and family that has my back. With them, I can tackle anything. Okay, now for the big question. Why did I get CAH in the first place?
A great question with a bit of a complex answer. You see, CAH is a genetic condition, which means a change in your gene causes it.
Genes are the instructions for making our bodies. They determine different things about your body, like hair and eye color, and height and build.
You get one set of genes from your mom and one from your dad.
CAH is caused by a change in the detailed instructions or coding within the gene. If you have CAH, it usually means your mom and dad are both carriers of this condition. The change in the gene in CAH keeps your body from making enough cortisol and aldosterone.
Carriers have one copy of the gene that is normal and one copy that has the gene change. Carriers have enough working hormones to keep them healthy.
Wow, okay, I think I've got all this, but let me make sure. CAH is a genetic condition that affects how my adrenal glands make hormones. My adrenal glands aren't working properly, and my body can't make enough cortisol and aldosterone. But my body makes more and more androgens. To treat CAH, the doctors need to give me replacement hormones. This helps keep my hormone levels balanced, including my androgens, and keeps me healthy. I'll need to take medicine every day, and even though that can be tough, I'm not alone and have a whole team to help me.
Perfect score, buddy.
Excellent summation. I believe you are now ready to return home. Activating teleporter.
Bye, Medikids, and thanks!
A few weeks later.
Yeah, life is like a roller coaster. It's got its ups and its downs. But I realized life is like a roller coaster in another important way. A way that makes the downs not so bad, because life, like a roller coaster, is fun.